since the fall of Rome, Western Europe had degenerated and spent 1,000 years bouldering in a time period known as the Dark Ages, a time of slow progress and little economic opportunity. But by the 14th century, the continent finally began to turn a corner and pull itself out of the darkness. In this lesson, we're going to learn about a fantastic time period that brought about the rebirth of education, science, technology, and art. This era is known as the Renaissance. The word Renaissance comes from the French, and it means rebirth. What was reborn? An intense interest in learning about the lost knowledge from classical Greek and Roman antiquity. Knowledge that had been lost since the fall of Rome. In order for the Renaissance to take place, a few things had to happen at once. First, a larger population had to live in towns and cities, not living in the rural countryside working their lord's land. This was necessary to boost the economy, create wealth, and spur trade. The Crusades and bubonic plague made that happen. The plague led to a shortage of agricultural laborers working their feudal lord's land, so the peasants demanded higher wages to compensate for doing the work of the deceased, as well as their own work. The lords either could not afford to pay this or resisted, so the peasants left and moved to towns. Another reason the peasants began moving to towns was to open a business along a crusade or trade route. In town, they became merchants, shopkeepers, and artisans. More business means more money flow. More money flow means investment in education, science, technology, and art. This all led to the expansion of trade. And to make matters even better, in Asia, the Mongols had reopened the Silk Road and made it relatively safe to travel. Once the Italian explorer Marco Polo had written his best-selling book about his adventures and the wealth he saw in China, many other Europeans were inspired to trade with the Far East. On top of all this, a big part that launched the Renaissance was a cultural movement known as humanism. It was a movement that began at the newly founded universities of Europe. It encouraged all individuals to become educated in the classical texts of the Greeks and the Romans. These texts included philosophy, literature, science, and art. Humanism stressed human achievement, and this ran counter to the traditional church teaching that your focus should be on improving your soul and on the afterlife. Yet now, a humanist believes that your focus should be on individual achievement and improving the world of the living. So now Europeans wanted to experiment, explore, and create. This, in return, resulted in progress. Another result that came from the humanist belief to pursue one's potential as an individual was a growing population that began to question the authorities of kings and the Catholic Church.
German money for the German church. The St. Peter line at German church.
The Christian reformer Martin Luther could not have been successful without the humanist movement that emerged during the Renaissance.
Christ did not command the preaching of indulgences, but of the gospel.
Forward this to Rome.
1/5 of the usual take. How will you explain this to Rome?
This drunken little German monk is intoxicated with himself. Sober him.
Ground zero for the emergence of the Renaissance was in Italy. There were many reasons for this. For one, the Roman ruins were located there to be studied. Second, when Constantinople fell to the Turks, Byzantine scholars smuggled classical texts to Rome in order to preserve and teach the ancient knowledge. And third, the major trade routes of Europe at that time passed right through northern Italy, making the cities there the richest in Europe. Each northern Italian city-state specialized in its own industry. Milan was known for metalwork. Venice concentrated on glassware. Florence's largest industry was banking, and its biggest players were the Medici family. The House of Medici first earned its wealth and prominence when it seized a monopoly on all the alum mined in northern Italy. Alum was used to make clothing more vibrant in its colors. With the money they raked in the textile industry, the family created the Medici Bank, the largest bank in Europe. With this bank, the Medici became the wealthiest family in Europe and ascended the family to great political power. I mean, the Medici produced 4 popes, 2 French queens, and basically ran the city of Florence. The family funded the invention of the piano, the construction of St. Peter's Basilica at the Vatican, and were patrons of the arts for such well-renowned Renaissance artists as Brunelleschi, Botticelli, Michelangelo, Raphael, Machiavelli, and the Renaissance man himself, Leonardo da Vinci. If it wasn't for the wealthy patrons of Europe, the Renaissance would never have happened. The Renaissance, in a sense, was a coming out of the darkness of medieval times. It was a rebirth of education, science, technology, literature, music, and art in general. The seeds of the modern world were sown and grown in the Renaissance. You might even say it launched modern life. Well, I hope you enjoyed our expedition of the Renaissance, and I'll see you again next time.
Siamo pronti!